for coming, and this is the great day for our university. It's a historic day, and I have great privilege and pleasure to introduce our today's speaker. Professor Tetsuro Matsuzawa, more than 40 years, is working as a primatologist, and he is a unique scientist because he working in the field and the laboratory. He is the author of over 200 papers and 4 books. Ethical authority defending primates' rights. A man who is an inspiration for many generations of Japanese scientists and also, of course, foreign researcher. For us also, for comparative psychology or comparative cognitive science. Distinguished Professor, Kyoto University Institute for Advanced Study. Professor, Primate Research Institute of Kyoto University. Coordinator, leading graduate program in primatology and wildlife science of Kyoto University. General Director, Japan Monkey Center. And also President of Academic Alpine Club of Kyoto. Ladies and gentlemen, a living legend of primatology, Professor Tetsuro Matsuzawa.
Good afternoon. Thank you very much for coming to my talk. It's my great pleasure and honor to talk about my study on chimpanzees. The title of today's talk, I put sharing. Sharing the time, sharing the place, sharing food, sharing the idea. That could be very much uniquely human. A human mind built from the study of chimpanzees. I have been studying the wild chimpanzees in their natural habitat in Africa. My fieldwork is done in Guinea, Conakry. And the site is called Bossou, B-O-S-S-O-U, so since 1986. I have been there every December, January. So this is a place. Using drone, I show the forest. And this is the laboratory, our field station. And it is nearby the big village. And surrounding forests are the place of chimpanzee they live. Could you turn off the light?
Yes.
The darker the better. Okay. Yes. So the chimpanzee in Bossou is well known to use a pair of stones to crack open nuts, oil palm nuts. Oil palm nuts has a hard shell. To get to the edible part called kernel, you have to crack open the hard shell using a pair of stones as hammer and anvil. Pick up a nut, place it on the anvil stone. And hit to crack up. By the way, she's left-hander. Always use left hand for hammering. Of course, the young chimpanzees right after the birth, can't crack open nuts. So it takes 4 or 5 years to start cracking, to start using stones as tools. 4 or 5 years. So this is a chimpanzee 3.5 years old. Can't crack it open. Then she goes to the nearby adult in such a close distance. Just looking. And adult never teach anything at all, no active teaching. Then the child return to the home position to continue, start cracking. So this is a way of chimpanzee learn to use stone tool. Did I make myself clear? So based on this observation, I named education by master apprenticeship. So no active teaching, the master means adults and mother show the right model. Then apprentice, the child, has a strong motivation to make the copy. And as far as the child want to do something, the adults are highly tolerant to allow them to do whatever they want. So that is packed into one label, education by master apprenticeship. So this is what I have done in the world. In the parallel airport, I have been studying chimpanzees in the laboratory, in the Primate Research Institute. My research partner is named I, spelled A-I, and pronunciation is just like I, and very popular girl name in Japan. So I project started in November 10th, 1977, when she arrived in Japan at the age of one. So since then, I have been with her to know the mind of the chimpanzee. So my research way is named participant observation. Participant. I'm participant. I participating in their life in captivity. So let me explain a little more the details. The Primate Research Institute of Kyoto University has a group of 12 chimpanzees. So it's a group of 12 chimpanzees. And in semi-natural environment, very high, 15 meters high climbing frame, and lot of trees and shrubs, and small stream. And a group of 12 chimpanzees are kept in this setting. So I'm not focusing a single chimpanzee eye, but focusing on a group of chimpanzees in which a chimpanzee lives. And in 2000, she gave the birth to her son named Ayumu. I means love, and Ayumu means walk, and a very popular boy name in Japan. As you see in the photograph, placenta and cord, so this is right after the birth. So I took the photo, this means I went into the cage of chimpanzee, inside of the cage, I took this photo. So that is what I mean, participant observation. I participate, I join in the life of chimpanzee in the laboratory. So the most well-known study of AI project is photographic memory of young chimpanzees. Ayumu, Kurio, Paul, three young chimpanzees showed extraordinary photographic memory. So the prerequisite is the ordering the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So every trial is unique. After touch circle, 9 numerals appear. So you have to touch 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. So the kids started to learn this task at the age of 4. And 6 months is good enough to learn 1 through 9. So now it's very clear chimpanzee had the knowledge of the order of 9 numerals. Okay? Based on this knowledge, exactly the same task. But after touch white circle, 9 numerals appear. Then after touch 1, the other numerals go on. The other numerals turn to white rectangles. Then you have to touch where 2 was, where 3 was, and where 4 was in this ascending order. I explained to you, so you may try. Okay? Voila. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay? After touch 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are there. Don't worry, no one can do it. I know you cannot do it. Chimpanzee touch 1 in 0.5 seconds. In this short latency, no one can do it. So based on this, the parallel efforts in the field and in the laboratory, I have learned a lot of things. And today, I want to focus on 4 major topics. 4 major topics. Based on the knowledge accumulated in the field work and also the laboratory work. The first topic is from 4 hands to 2 legs. Many of you still believe that four-legged animals standing up and in the course of human evolution, four-legged animals standing up and the 40 arms liberated, free from locomotion, and the freed hand started to use objects and started to become tools. And using tools, then stimulate the brain enlarge. So that is a scenario everywhere. But I say no, it's not. In the human evolution among primates, we evolved from 4 hands to 2 legs. The second topic is stable supine posture. Supine is lying on the back. So the human baby lying on the back, that is very uniquely human. The third one is trade-off language and memory. And the final topic is sharing. The title of today's talk, Sharing Makes Us Human. So let's move on one by one. The first topic is from 4 hands to 2 legs. Let's start from Japanese monkey or snow monkey. We have monkeys in Japan, and in winter, a group of monkeys love to hot bathing. Not many people recognize an important point. No monkeys and apes in Europe and North America. Polish monkeys? German monkeys? French monkeys? American monkeys? British monkeys? No. Primates are 400, 500 species at the moment. Primates distribute in the green area on the map. So this means Central South America, Africa, India, Southeast Asia, including China and Japan. So this means no monkeys and apes in Europe and North America. And another important point, Japan. Japanese monkey is the northern limit of the monkeys. So thanks to this natural environment, we have an indigenous monkey. So Japan has been taking the leading role in the study of primates, primatology. Okay, based on this thing, just I want to tell you an important concept of primates, phylogeny of primates. So primates, as Japanese monkey, gorilla, chimpanzee, bonobo, humans, whatever. Important point is, all belong to primates family. So you cannot say humans and primates. You may say humans and rodents. Humans and rodents are different, but humans and primates, no, primates means including you yourself. So primates including human and non-human primates, monkeys and apes. So human and the other non-human primates, that makes the family primates. Okay, so please focus on the family primates. So what is primates? To ask about what is uniquely human, let's start to ask what is primates. Primates is arboreal, so that is the point. Many other mammals, so primates is one of mammals, but many other mammals are terrestrial. Terrestrial means moving on the ground. Terrestrial. So that mammals has four legs. Okay? Four legs. And the common ancestor of mammals in the era of dinosaur, it's a terrestrial, nocturnal, small, such as rats and mice. They are the ancestral form of mammals. So four-leg animals. Accept, yes, four-leg animals. We humans evolved from four-leg animals. But we primates evolved from four-leg animals. But look at the adaptation of four-leg animals to a different environment. Bats, flying in the sky. Bats are mammals. And look at the wing. It looks like wing, but there are hands and foot. So four-leg animals flying into the sky tend to have wings. Four legs to wings. Look at dolphins and whales, the adaptation to aquatic life. So in the water, their four legs tend to become just like fins of the fishes. Okay, so four-leg animals, four legs on the ground, but wings in the sky and fins in the water. And how about monkeys? Walking on the ground, four legs, but when they stop like this. Okay? Body trunk is horizontal, but stop to become vertical. Why they stop vertical? So, it's not human make the upright position. No, that is a common feature of primates. Primates has the upright posture to climb up to the tree. To climb up the tree, body trunk horizontal to the ground, it's not good. It should be vertical to climb up to the trees. A month ago, I was in Yunnan, China to study snub-nosed monkeys. So snub-nosed monkeys, a species of monkeys moving in the tree, not on the ground, in the tree. So imagine the monkeys moving from one branch to the next. They do have to grasp the branches. So four legs tend to become four hands. So four hands to grasp the branches. So just like four-legged animals on the ground, moving up to the trees, that turn to become four hands. Look at Japanese monkey again. This is a footprint on the sand. Hand and foot, but foot look like hand. Even chimpanzee, look at the foot. It look like hand. So chimpanzee has four hands because chimpanzees are arboreal. They have to grasp the branches. So please don't forget, all primates has four hands. That is unique. Why primates is popping up in among mammals? Because we have four hands in here. Even gorillas. Gorilla, foot. Gorilla is quite a lot on the ground, but gorilla is also arboreal, climbing trees, and the foot look like hand. And only human is unique because of not the hand, but the foot. Human foot is very unique. And I went to Turkana, Kenya, to see the footprints of Homo habilis. So Homo habilis footprints and my foot looks similar. So we are Homo, the same Homo, because we have the foot. So please change your mind, not four-legged animals standing up to make the hands, no. Four-legged animals move onto the trees, turn to become primates that have four hands. And from four hands primates, we humans started to climb down to the ground again, to walk long distance on the savanna. So the hand turned to become foot. So that is a true story, a true evolutionary scenario of human evolution. Let me move on to stable supine posture, the second topic. You look at the baby lying on the back. It's everywhere in our everyday situation. But if you put baby chimpanzee on the back, very strange posture. Chimpanzee lift up the right arm and left leg. Then 5-6 seconds later, left arm and right leg. Then 5-6 seconds later again, right arm and left leg. Lift it up. So I saw this strange behavior 30 years ago. I had no idea why they do such a thing. But then I had an opportunity to see orangutan baby lying on the back, exactly the same. Chimpanzee, orangutan. Chimpanzee. Chimpanzee, orangutan, it's the same. What do? They are trying to cling to the mother because they are in the tree. The baby, suppose that they release their hands, drop. So the newborn has to cling to the baby. So always cling to the baby, never separated from the mother lying on the back. That is possible only humans because we are terrestrial. We are terrestrial primates, so put the baby on the ground and the baby do not have to cling the mother by the hands. So hands are free, free from clinging. So stable supine posture, supine, lying on the back, has the unique human behavior like neonatal smiling in a human infant. As you see, the baby smile, as you know, the baby smile, so spontaneously smile. I was so happy to see the baby smile. But if you carefully look at the baby's face, you may recognize that it's not directed to the father and mother because the eyes are closed. Eyes are closed. In 3 months, now the baby started to show social smiling, means eyes open, targeted to you and smile. But in the neonatal stage, they have the innate tendency to smile, spontaneously smile, to get the attention of the adults. So adults are so much seduced, attracted to the smiling baby. That is done in the supine posture, because the baby not clinging to the breast, but on the ground, so you can have the face-to-face communication, looking into eyes and smiling. So looking into eyes and smile, that is very much uniquely human. Monkeys, they don't like to be stared. So direct gaze is not good for monkeys. But we humans, because of physical separation of mother and the infant takes a supine posture, so that a lot of face-to-face communication and vocal exchange. Not many people recognize that only human babies cry in the night. Chimpanzee baby never cry because always cling to the mother. Suppose that you feel hungry, you get the nipple by yourself. But in the case of humans, the baby has to cry to get the attention of the mother. And this kind of things, like the mother say, wait a minute, I'm coming. So this kind of vocal exchange tend to become speech in the later stage. And the third point of supine posture makes us human is manipulation by free hands. As I have mentioned, lying on the back means the body is supported by the back, so hands are free. Let me repeat again and again. It's not four-legged animals moving and standing up, hands free. No. Right after the birth, hands are free in humans. Human babies stand up at the age of one. But before age of one, right after the birth, human babies' hands are free because of the stable supine posture. Hands are free so that grasp the rattles, toys, and from one hand to the other by a mouse. So this kind of lot of manipulation, object manipulation, is uniquely human in the very early stage of the life. So let me proceed to the third topic, that is a trade-off of language and memory. So chimpanzee has their own way of communication, vocal communication. As you see in the photograph, open the mouth like this, and in this shape, the chimpanzee emit the voice like then the chimpanzee 500 meter away or 1 kilometer away respond the same shape of the mouse. That means hello. So they exchange the voice like this to say hello. And it's far away, but you may have passed that direction a day before. And now that, oh, huge fig trees gave the fruits. So that, I know that is, from the voice, I can recognize who he is, and he must be there eating fig trees. So I want to join him. So that is their way up long distance call. Then they come approach to see each other in a close distance. Now they start to emit a different voice like say hello again. And after greeting, suppose that they start join in the fig trees, or they start to eat something like fig fruits. Now they emit a different voice like means tasty. After eating, chimpanzee may take a big rest, but the kids, young chimpanzees, love to play each other and love play like wrestling, chasing. Now they emit a different voice, something like laughter, laughing sounds like. So they have their own unique vocal repertoire. But, and if you carefully count the number, it must be 30 to 40 vocal repertoire you can recognize. But is that the language? Chimpanzee vocalization, is this language? Maybe yes, maybe not. Well, according to our everyday definition of language, language must have the grammar, a more complex structure. So there might be a different question. The chimpanzees, do they learn human language? Do they have the capability of learning human language? So that was an original question in 1960s and 70s. So 20th century, a lot of scientists rushed to find the answer to the question, do chimpanzees learn human language? So IE project started as one of the attempt of teaching language to the chimpanzee. So in my case, right from the beginning, I use a computer-mediated system. So fully automated computer system and teaching letters, not sign language, not vocal language, but letters. I try to teach Japanese letters to the chimpanzee. So this is the situation of touchscreen panel in which 10 Japanese letters and a color blue. So I try to teach color names to the chimpanzee. White goes to this letter. Color green goes to this letter. Color brown goes to this letter. Purple. So color is coded to the corresponding letter, orange, yellow, okay? Then the reverse, pink, decodes the letter. What is this letter? Brown. Red. Sorry, easy for Japanese. It's a bit difficult for English. Green. Gray. And blue. Okay? So, color to code, code to color, color to letter, Japanese letter, and Japanese letter decoded into the color. So, both ways. So, at least in the color naming, chimpanzee succeeded to learn the Japanese letter or geometric figure, a lozenge and horizontal line means red. And the naming system in chimpanzees. They can do it, not only I, but also the other chimpanzee can master this kind of naming color by the Japanese letters. But it was not so easy because, for example, color red, it does not remind me or reminds us of any specific pattern. Because I was Japanese, so I learned the letter to mean, to have the meaning of red. In contrast to it, in the course of teaching the number, number is logical mathematical skill, a part of language, I found a very interesting phenomenon, what I called photographic memory. Okay, let's go back to that one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So at a look, chimpanzee recognize which number appeared in which position. So we invented this task called masking task in 2000 and published a paper about extraordinary memory in 2007, and a decade later now, people are convincing that chimpanzee has extraordinary memory. But at the beginning, when we reported this capability, a lot of criticism and skeptical comments from the scholars, especially from the West. From you. Partly because of the strong religious belief of Christianity. So Christianity discriminates humans and animals. You say humans and animals. In the biological viewpoint, humans is a part of, in a member of animal kingdom, not the plants. So humans and animals dichotomy is wrong. Human is a member of animal kingdom. But anyway, not many people are happy. So they said like overtraining, how much training you gave, and many, many other comments. So I invented the extreme case like seven numerals. So two numerals are randomly missing. So you have to touch the numerals in ascending order. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so 4 and 9 are missing. 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 2 and 6 are missing. Wow, difficult. It doesn't matter. Chimpanzee know the sequence, the order of seven numerals. Okay? You can do it. But how about this? Seven numerals, but seven numerals are shown very briefly, only 0.2 seconds. So you can recognize the numbers appeared on the screen. You can see. You know the numbers are there. But you may not be able to understand seven numerals. But chimpanzee can do it. Look at it. Sorry, I cannot explain. Okay? So seven numerals in an ascending order. I tested my students. The same place, same procedure, same apparatus. And their performance was zero, 0%. So it's not a matter of training, 0%, so no hope. It's impossible for us to do it, but they can do it. And they can do it, 7 numerals, photographic memory. But even the chimpanzees, they need concentration. He lost his attention because the sound in the earth outside. But 10 seconds later, he can do it. So, chimpanzee has an extraordinary photographic memory, and at least for 10 seconds, it continues. So then I postulated trade-off hypothesis of language and memory. So the common ancestor about 5-6 million years ago, bottom is human and top is chimpanzee, and there are in between a lot of fossil hominids like Australopithecus or Homo erectus, all gone. So chimpanzee is the closest relative. And chimpanzees still have immediate memory or photographic memory, but we lost it. Why? In return, we acquire the power of language. In certain point of the evolution, the brain capacity is limited, like Homo habilis, 800 milliliter. So in the constrained, limited capacity, to get a new function like language, you have to lose some other functions. So that was the scenario in the evolution. We humans lost, for example, motor capability like chimpanzees. We lost the odor capability, but we acquired a lot of other things. And why this kind of immediate memory or photographic memory that provides a basis of quick decision is important in chimpanzee. Why it is important? One plausible explanation is the case like patrolling the territory. So two neighboring communities are agonistic in chimpanzees. Suppose that patrolling chimpanzee recognized the bush is moving. For us, the bush is moving. But chimpanzee can easily recognize how many enemies and where. Then quicker decision to how many allies to go or to retreat. So that's important. Otherwise, if you fail, it's really fatal result. So killing is not so rare in chimpanzees. We accumulated 153 killing of wild chimpanzees. So chimpanzee killing each other. So the final topic is sharing. The message is sharing makes us human. As I have shown you, all of the chimpanzees, 12 chimpanzees in my primate research institute, they learn the Arabic numerals. So they can touch from small number to large number. But in this setting, what we call computer ahina, two chimpanzees facing to one computer, but the computer is divided into two halves, left half and right half. In between, there is a translucent glass. So it's clear, translucent, but you cannot touch. Left chimpanzee cannot touch right half, while right chimpanzee cannot touch left half, prevented by the glass. Do I make myself clear?
Yes.
Thank you. So this chimpanzee has the left chimpanzee has 2, 3, 5, 8, and the other chimpanzee right side has 1, 4, 6, 7, and both chimpanzees know the order of the sequence. So you may expect left chimpanzee touch the numbers, while the other chimpanzee independently touch the numbers from small number to large number. But if you put the two chimpanzees together at the same time, you can see a very beautiful collaboration almost from the beginning. Touch, touch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Clear? So chimpanzee collaborate. Touch, touch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And next trial. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So chimpanzee can do it. They can beautifully collaborate. But in a different task that is invented by Shinya Yamamoto, my junior colleague, it's a helping behavior. It's not collaboration. It's collaboration. But not to get the mutual benefit. One-sided. So a chimpanzee is extending the arm to try to get the stick given by the other chimpanzee. So this kind of situation. In this situation, the chimpanzee up needs a stick to retrieve an object beyond the reach. So to retrieve the object, she needs a stick. So in such a situation of two boosts together, one is the chimpanzee who really needs a tool to get to access to the food, and the other chimpanzee has toolbox, toolkits, but no access to the food. Okay? In this trial, the chimpanzee to the right needs a straw to drink a juice. So behind a tiny hole, you use a straw into the hole to drink the juice. You can see the juice, but no straw is available. Then the chimpanzee left side is provided a toolbox, toolkit. There are 7 tools: stick, rope, straw. So what happens? Give me. Give me. No word straw, so give me. But not really. So playing with rope, then give me. Finally gave it. And please take a note, it's straw. It was straw. So this chimpanzee knows what is necessary for the other chimpanzee. So she knows, but she doesn't want to give. Because that is her toolkit. Okay? So this chimpanzee doesn't want to give, even request it. So request again and again and again, and upon request, finally the chimpanzee gives a thing to the neighbor. So this is chimpanzee nature. They can collaborate if they get both get the food. But if it is one-sided, a person in trouble to give a hand That is human. So the same tendency is proved in a different situation like this, using eye tracker. Eye tracker is the apparatus to detect where you see your fixation. So left side is the eye tracker test of human baby, 1 year old. The right side is chimpanzee. And both subjects are facing to the eye tracker computer monitor. So eye tracker is in the bottom. And the computer monitor is just like the TV screen. And the videotape is shown to the subject. That is orange bottle. And the young lady hold the orange bottle and pour the juice into the cup. So the same thing was presented to the subjects, human subject and chimpanzee subject. Where do they see? Yellow dots and red dots, that is the focal point. That is the place fixated. They saw the place. Let's go to chimpanzee case. It's very clear, chimpanzee watched orange juice. That's all, that's it. Chimpanzee always watched orange juice. But human baby, look at the orange juice and look up to the young lady, the face, and look down the orange juice, and look up again, and look down the orange juice. So exactly the same situation, exactly the same scene, but chimpanzee way of seeing this world is me and orange juice. But humans, baby, is me, orange juice, and you. So three times, me, you, and the object. But chimpanzee is only two items, two times, me and the object. So this clearly shows that you in front of me, you are a very important component of this perceptual world. That is human. So I have been studying chimpanzees for decades in the world and very much seduced to the mother-infant relationship. So I'm very much impressed by the mother and infants in chimpanzees. And I went to Congo Zaire to see wild bonobos. Again, mother and infant, very interesting. Then I went to Rwanda, Uganda to see mountain gorillas. Mountain gorilla is very interesting, mother and infant. And I went to Borneo and Sumatra to see wild orangutans. Again, mother and infant is very, very impressive. So, chimpanzee, bonobo, gorilla, orangutan. They are hominid family. Hominid, not primate, hominid means humans, chimpanzees, bonobos, gorillas, and orangutan make one family, hominid. We are hominid, different from monkeys because we have no tails. Not many people recognize chimpanzee no tail, bonobo no tail, gorilla no tail, orangutan no tail, monkeys have tails. So we are big monkeys that have no tail. So we are the same member. And if you carefully look at the mother-infant relationship, you can see a lot of altruistic behavior. Giving a hand. What is uniquely human? Giving a hand. But that is to some extent shared by the chimpanzee. Chimpanzee mother give a hand to the baby. This is a scene of a young baby moving from one branch to the next, but the gap is huge. Then the baby climbs whimpers, like whoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Then the mother look back and they give a hand. Or we found the role of grandmother. Well, grandmother is believed to be uniquely human, but very exceptional case like Bosu, we found grandmothering. So grandmother is using stone, and in this case, the young chimpanzee, that is grandchild of this old lady, put a nut on the anvil stone, and that nut was hit by the grandmother, and the kernel was taken by the baby. So this is altruistic behavior. And the transportation, grandmother, grandchild was getting on the ride of the back of the grandmother. So traveling the risky road, as you see the front is the mother with newborn baby. This mother has two children, young baby with the mother, and a big one is with the grandmother. So this kind of helping behavior is in chimpanzees. So to some extent, you can see this kind of giving a hand or helping behavior in chimpanzees, and very intimate relationship between mother and infant. But if you go to see the human society, I went to Cameroon, in the forest in Cameroon, very unique place. You can see humans, chimpanzees, and gorilla in the same forest. They are living in the same place. The humans called pygmy. So this is Baka pygmy, ethnic group. I saw their life in the wild. A lot of helping behavior from the elder sibling to the young, or grandmothering. So grandmother helped the grandchild, giving the food, sharing food with the child, and a big family. So family, a lot of children, and they are helping each other in the very humble hut, cottage. So when I see these life of so-called hunter-gatherers, I recognize that multiple individuals like mother, father, grandmother, grandfather, uncle, aunts, brother, sister, so everyone come together to collaborate to raise the children, so multiple children. That is a way of life of humans. So what is uniquely human? In the shortest words, that is imagination. So we have the power of imagination. But the power of imagination for what? For what? Is for understanding others' mind, or sharing and giving. So this kind of altruistic behavior is coming from the power of imagination. I can imagine your mind. I can imagine your needs. And as a result, we spontaneously share and give. So, or you may say love. So mutual support, that is uniquely human. But I don't say chimpanzee cannot imagine. So the concluding episode is rudimentary form of imagination in chimpanzee. So in this setting, I'm testing AI chimpanzee. And Ayumu has nothing to do, so he collected the wooden blocks, four wooden blocks, and retrieving, walking backward with wooden blocks in the hands, and he has nothing to do. And I'm using the same set of wooden blocks to ask Ai to copy the model, blue, yellow, red brick to the tower. Then look at Ayumu. Ayumu pretending to collect the wooden block. pretending to collect the wooden blocks. It is so funny. So graduate students laughed and he protested. So let's look at the different angles, the same scene. Ayumu, nothing to do, now got up, start pretense to avoid the real red block, because it's pretense, so real one must be avoided. So he pretended to have the imaginary blocks in the hand and retrieving, walking back. And look at the face. Open mouth means play, so this is play. And it was laughed by the graduate student. So he got upset and stopped it. So that was the story. So I don't say chimpanzee has don't have the power of imagination, but it's so rich in humans. So we have the power of imagination, and the result, we share the time, place, food, whatever, information, and so on. And just I want to add a tiny part about social outreach of our research. So based on our research, of course, I do the education of the graduate students, but also the social outreach. We are running a Japan Monkey Center, that is a zoo and museum of non-human primates. Japan Monkey Center was founded in 1956, more than 60 years. But 4 years ago, that was private zoo and museum, but moved to Kyoto University professors. So Japan Monkey Center is the next door of Kyoto University Primate Research Institute. So Kyoto University is just like your university, national university, but to the north, that is Japan Monkey Center. So it was an amusement park and zoo, but divided into two pieces. West side is continue to be amusement park run by private sector, but the right side, eastern side, is a zoo and museum run by Kyoto University professors. So I take the role of the general director and the editor-in-chief of Primates, the oldest journal in English about primatology. So Japan Monkey Center is proud of having the English journal of primates, and also we started in Japanese, it says Monkey. It's a magazine for kids, and you can free access to the back number. So please go to japanmonkeycenter.org, and Monkey, you can see the what kind of magazine we are publishing. And based on Japan Monkey Center, we do the conservation, what we call Green Corridor, Green Corridor Project, connecting Bosu chimpanzee to Nimba chimpanzee. That is World Natural Heritage Site, so tree planting project. And I lost very old chimpanzee at the age of 58 last year, and made it to the skeletal specimen. And the number of chimpanzees is decreasing very much in Bosu. So we try to connect Bosu to Nimba. So in between there is a savanna, brown area. So you do the planting trees between Nimba and Bosu. About 10,000 young trees every year you make and put into the savanna to make the small forest. And in Japan Monkey Center, you can see free-ranging squirrel monkey. We have the world's largest collection of 60 species of non-human primates. And squirrel monkeys in Amazon, you can see the monkeys free-ranging, and in a very close distance, you can see the monkeys just like I went to Amazon a couple of years ago to see the free-ranging wild monkeys. This is woolly monkey. And I recognize in Amazon, when I went there, you have to use canoe, kayak, to approach to squirrel monkey, because Amazon is so huge. So rain season and dry season, the water level is about 10 meters difference. So the forest is in the water. So you have to use a canoe, kayak. So I introduced kayak to Japan Water Center. So ask my president to use kayak to see the monkeys. And ringtail lemur are in Madagascar, very charming creatures, ringtail lemurs. Again, this is free ranging. So you can see the free ranging ringtail lemur in Japan Monkey Center, or even closer, So there is a museum activity for environmental education. So about 150,000 visitors a year, and more than 280 schools a year we have. And this year is a special exhibition of art. So chimpanzees love to draw the paintings. No reward, nothing, they love to draw. This is a masterpiece of AI chimpanzee. So please come to Japan, come to Kyoto to see the beautiful temples, shrines, and gardens, but also visit Japan Monkey Center, please. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. On the end of this meeting, the students of the Department of Psychology want to say a few words to Professor Matsuzawa.
Thank you.